Hi everybody, my name is Ioannis Anifantakis. Today we're going to take a look at how to implement a RecyclerView equivalent with sticky headers using Jetpack Compose step by step. Our project consists of 5 demos. Each demo improves on the previous one. We're going to have 2 parts. The first part will contain demo 1, 2, and 3, and it will be a more basic approach. And then we will have a more involved approach at demo 4 and 5. Before attempting the project, make sure you have the latest version of Android Studio installed. As of now, it is Android Studio Arctic Fox, which is available on the stable channel. This is the minimum version in order to create an application using Jetpack Compose. So, press New Project. Having that version, you should see Empty Compose Activity. Select that and press Next. Let's call our application Compose App and press Finish. The first thing to note is that there is no XML layout created for our new activity. The reason is we're going to build our UI directly with the composable functions. Additionally, Jetpack Compose provides you columns, rows, and boxes. You can think of columns and rows as linear layout containers with their items aligned vertically and horizontally respectively, and boxes as a relative layout equivalent. For our demo 1, we will build a list view equivalent using Jetpack Compose. It is a necessary knowledge before moving to demo 2, where we will build a recycler view equivalent. To start, let's remove some of the default code so we start fresh with our first composable function. Composable functions are top-level functions, so they are declared outside any class. Let's start with the composable annotation and let's name our first composable function scrollable column demo. In order to call it, we need to do that from the setContent block, which is the equivalent of setContentView. So, let's start by the column, which we need to import. As we already said, columns are the equivalent of linear layouts whose items are vertically stacked. So it's the ideal component to use in order to display several lines of text vertically as a list. So let's print 200 lines of text. So let's emit some text. And to make it appear a little bit more dynamic, let's also do the iteration number. Now, to make this appear more like a cell inside a table, let's also put a border at the end of the text by using a divider whose color will be, let's say, color gray, for example, and with a thickness of 1 dp. Let's import dp as well. And now let's run this, see how this looks. And it works. However, the text is very small and we cannot scroll it. So let's fix that. Let's start with the text. We will use named parameters here to introduce more features. So let's say that we want to also have a font size of 36 SP, and we need to also import SP. And we will also be using a padding. For that, we will need a modifier to have a padding of, let's say, 8 dp. Now let's run again and see how it looks. And it does look much better. However, it's still not scrollable. Now, if this was a linear layout, in order to make it scrollable, we would need to include this inside the scroll view. We will do something similar here. We will declare a variable, and we'll call it scroll state. And it will be of remember scroll state. Now, we need to use this scroll state inside our column. So we will use a modifier here. And for that, we will declare a vertical scroll to be our scroll state. And that's it. Let's see again how this goes. And run it. And it does work. It displays persons from 1 to 200. And that's how a list view works. So what did we do? We created a text followed by a divider composable object 200 times inside the for loop. These composable components are nested inside a column composable component, which is the equivalent of a vertical linear layout. For this column to be scrollable, we declared a vertical scroll state, which is the equivalent of attaching a linear layout to a scroll view. Now, the above approach suffers from performance issues as we create all the UI, even for the elements outside the viewable area, which is how list views work. RecyclerViews exist to address that problem. So let's see how we can improve on that code.